Okay, so we can start again. Welcome back, everyone, for this last session. We have the pleasure now to welcome Mr. Bartosz Zambrzycki, who is the West specialist at DG Sante at the European Commission. Mr. Zambrzycki is with us this afternoon in order to tell us about the next perspectives, the future of the European Union programs regarding the farm to fork strategy. Before I let the floor to Mr. Zambrzycki, I can tell all the participants, but because the agenda of Mr. Zambrzycki is quite full today, I suggest we take some moment after his presentation for a Q&A session directly, because our speaker cannot stay with us for the next panel with the policymakers. So I suggest we take a round of Q&A just after Mr. Zambrzycki presentation. So now I give the floor to Mr. Zambrzycki from DG Sante about the European Union farm to fork strategy and the new or renewed European Union ambition regarding food waste. So the floor is yours, Mr. Zambrzycki, and you can share your screen for sharing your presentation. Thank you.
Thank you. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, I can stay you for sure about until 4 o'clock. If longer, then it's risky. So yes, that's why I asked to have the questions first. So let me share my screen. Okay, so my name is Bartosz Zambrzycki. I'm working in DG Health and Food Safety in the newly established unit Farm to Fork, where I deal with the food waste, mostly on the link between food and waste legislation, including food waste measurement. So what I show you today is, you probably have seen it before, because it's a bit of our standard presentation on farm to fork. Well, until now, we do not have yet anything more. But I allow you to read the slides yourself, while I try to give you some more descriptions and explanations from behind the screen. So basically, the goals of farm to fork strategy are those climate, global transition, opportunities, resilience. I mean, you should think about farm to fork strategy as a new circular economy, but dedicated to food only. So now we have the circular economy to zero, and now in parallel exists a farm to fork strategy. Having this strategy, of course, is a big step for us. Some of you may remember that in 2013, the Commission worked on the communication of sustainable food. Then it has been rejected as well for different reasons, but of course, it was then seen as not politically necessary, too ambitious. And now, 7 years later, everything is overturned. That now we see it as a political priority, and we strongly go forward with these challenges. So speaking about what we think about sustainable food system, the first things are, of course, environmental impact. So they should be as neutral or positive as possible. The second thing now, more for DG Sante, food security and public health. So access to food, but also allow that that food is not only safe but healthy. So the diet is balanced diet, is good for the health. Then preservation. So it means both economic, social issue, but also I would say the to protect also the farmers. So allow the single market to function, allow the international trade to function, while still makes the market working and without overthrowing what EU has achieved by now, which I would say that we are the leader in the world of the food quality, of the food safety. In the strategy, we have four targets which we like to aim for sustainable food production. Because speaking of sustainability is one thing, now transferring into numbers is the second thing. So we would like to to reduce use and risk of chemical pesticides. We would like to reduce nutrient losses, so better fertilization. So it means we could reduce the use of fertilizers. The antimicrobial resistance is a very important thing. So we would like to reduce sales and use of antimicrobials by 50%. And organic farming, to increase organic farming to 25% of EU rules on organics. Of course, this means that we should now integrate work of everyone. This is, I would say, the big leap from the past, where we work more on, well, there was colleagues from DG Environment who work on environmental protection, the colleagues from agriculture focus on farmers, DG Sante focus on food health, DG Grow focus on functioning of the market, of the food supply chain. Now it's something which is to go across all the competences within the European Commission, but it also means that it in fact works across all the competences for all participants. So starting from citizens, then we have here different participants of the food supply chain, so from farmers, processors, manufacturers, retailers, food services. And then we have NGOs, we have financial services, advisor, a lot of importance for research providers, and international level going beyond EU. Mostly on the international trade and global environmental impacts. Okay. And of course, it means addressing different levels of governments and a large selection of instruments. So starting from hard legislation, then to financial incentives, to help in education, research and innovation is a powerful tool, and the also where a lot of funding will go, procurement, I mean public procurement, and also voluntary commitments in various levels as a way to integrate the efforts of different actors of the chain. So now coming to concrete action. So the general overarching is to prepare kind of legislative framework for sustainable food systems. We have a legislative framework for food, the general food law from 2002, but it was done after the safety crisis and in fact was focused on the food safety. Now we have another challenges for which we need also a good framework to put our instruments in. So we will work on a legislative framework for sustainable food systems, which provides these general principles. It should be then basis to ensure the policy coherence at EU and national level. So to put us in close contact and cooperation with farmers, industry, consumers. And then provisions of governance on collective involvement of stakeholders. The parallel development much quicker will be something which has been sparked by the COVID crisis, so contingency plan for ensuring food supply and security in times of crisis. Then the further set of actions. I would say it was raised this earlier that how the sustainable food production will function together with common agricultural policy. So basically, our first aim is to provide recommendations to member states addressing these 9 specific objectives of CAP. So the member states can include them for submitting the CAP strategic plans. And then, of course, it means that that member states has a freedom to adopt these recommendations, but they should take them into account. Something very concrete is a revision of directive of sustainable use of pesticides, which is planned for 2022. Similar revision of regulation, plant protection products containing biological active substance already for next year. Action plan for the organic sector. Now it's planned for this year and should cover the whole financial planning from 2021 to 2026. And also action plan for integrated nutrient management 2021. Then the next set is revision of the animal welfare rules, proposal of revision for feed additives. I think that here this is important as the feed additives has a great potential to reduce climate impacts from livestock. So in terms of environmental impacts, it will be one of legislation delivering the highest input. Then what we would like is then to help cooperation with the food supply chain, so enhance cooperation of primary producers, clarification of scope of competitions rules to take sustainability more into account, and the data collection exercise for farm sustainability data network. There is also a pack for aquaculture. So we have the common fisheries policy. But I would say that now the money and interest goes now a lot into aquaculture. So. As it's marked here, Maritime and Fisheries Fund will spend a lot of money to support sustainable seafood farming. We are to adopt new guidelines on aquaculture, intensify fight against fraud, and adopt EU strategy on algae. Concerning how the, not food producers, but how actors of the food supply chain, so food industry, retail, and restaurants, hospitality, food services should act. Well, again, there is a more general provision to try to incorporate sustainability into corporate governance framework. Code and monitoring framework for responsible business and marketing conduct, Now something goes more into the diet, stimulate reformulation of processed foods, so maximum level for certain nutrients, nutrient profiles to restrict promotion of unhealthy foods, so food high in salt, sugar, or fat. Part specific now, link between environment and food, so proposal of revision of legislation on food contact materials. I would say this is always important, as basically of package. There is never ending war between food and packaging. So whether the how to make the packaging at the same time safe for food, but also easy to recycle and environmentally friendly. But also it means that, for instance, for food waste prevention, we would favor more complex packaging, also providing additional information about state of food. But again, how it fits with the food contact materials, there is a big area for research and progress in industry here. We are to revise marketing standards, so the marketing standards are not in conflict with the sustainability rules. Again, something we work across the whole commission as to find a compromise which would fit everyone. I mentioned already the food fraud. Concerning the promotion of healthy food, we have mandatory criteria for sustainable fruit food procurement. I would say what we are intended to do is to think how to deliver them. Not we are not yet at the stage that we know this criteria already, but rather how to put them into use. While of course we work also in parallel of assessing food sustainability, assessing the impacts, environmental impacts from food. The review of school scheme. There is a focus on healthy and sustainable food. EU promotion program. Harmonized mandatory front of pack nutrition labeling, so the consumers can make more conscious choices. As you have heard Professor Ward, that everything starts and ends for consumers. So if we like to influence them, we should give them proper information. In the same group, there is a proposal for origin indication of certain products, and then also on sustainable food labeling framework. We also think about what is discussed now, whether VAT rates can be adapted to support more healthier and more sustainable food. Okay, so now this is what we like to achieve. This is our strategy, our aims. Now, how we want to help this transition to happen. So basically, the process is ongoing. I mean that already in the past, there was a trend towards sustainability, but we want to reinforce them. Basically, first is on funding. So now the funding are to be focused on research, innovation, investment. So we have a lot of funding for research in Horizon 2020, Horizon Europe. Also, what is not mentioned here, but I will come back to it later a bit. Specific funds for Green Deal, which also have a component on Farm to Fork, EFRD. Then the second thing is advisory services, data and knowledge. So basically this is like project on which we are meeting today is basically, as I understood, this knowledge sharing. So how to how to share this knowledge among the actors of the food supply chain. Here, of course, we have now more focus at the beginning of the sustainable farm management, farm sustainability data network, so the producers have better access to monitor economic, environmental, climate performance, also support for food processors, small retail food service operators, so the new business models can be easily taken. I mean, we cannot, if we think about sustainability, it cannot be only limited to the EU. So it means that we need to support developing countries in their transition, also include the sustainability now in the bilateral trade agreements. I guess that it will not be an easy task and it will be a big discussion on that, but at least needs started. Then sustainability, we like to promote sustainability via international standard setting bodies, so codex, and also in international fora and events. And United Nations Food Summit next year is expected to be one of such bodies. So also that means that for when importing food to Europe, then environmental aspects will take be more and more into account, specifically yes, for pesticide substances. And again, the promotion of appropriate labeling schemes so we can gradually move towards a sustainable way of production of food. And now I would focus more on my hobby horse, because I would say that as I have kind of general overview on farm to fork, while my real area of work is food loss and waste, which has small but important part in the farm to fork strategy. So the farm to fork strategy provides two main issues: the proposal for EU level targets for food waste reduction and revise of date marking rules. So I will describe them in a moment. But first, I would like to recall in previous strategies, so the food waste part of the Circular Economy Action Plan, we have set a solid foundation for further work on food waste. So first, we have established the platform, and in my view, the platform is quite or even very successful. The platform at the end of last year provided its own recommendations for action in food waste prevention. So they are not recommendations from Commission, but this time from member states and participants of the food supply chain. Then we put a solid legislation framework into EU waste legislation. So the waste directive has been amended. It introduced food waste definition, food waste measurement methodology, obligations for member states to reduce food waste, out of which the most important is obligation to prepare national food waste prevention programs. I heard, for instance, the echo of this, for instance, in presentation from Catalan, that yes, the government has to adopt the program. The regional strategy is a part of response to national programs. So now it seems that no government can avoid it, that at least needs to sit down, think about the problem, include their proposals into national program. What we have also achieved is on food donation guidelines, and now conduct a pilot project on food redistribution. the important thing, I would say small, but the member could make a difference of several, a few million tons turned away from waste, are guidelines of how to use food no longer intended for human consumption for feed. The feed industry is very big in Europe. A lot of food waste is being avoided by turned into animal feed. But again, with the way our legislation provides safety, it means that there are sometimes risk of misunderstanding, and we like to clarify that. As for final thing, better use understanding of date marking, it's still in progress, and it's expected to result in a new proposal. So yes, as I mentioned, there are these three main elements: targets, date marking, and investigate food losses and production stage and the ways of preventing them. But while the first two are legislative, the third one is a research one. So I will come back for a moment. So while this is this strong part of the strategy, so this is the soft one. So basically mobilizing the players across the EU and scaling up actions, because we have already a lot of experience from member states, including late member states. I mean, we have, of course, a lot of experience also from UK and its RAP foundation. There is a lot of experience at regional and local level, and what we would like to speed up, mostly by using platforms, speed up the uptake of this knowledge all around Europe, to integrate the food loss and waste in all relevant EU policies, and it means we would like to have it on par, for instance, with climate policies, because food loss and waste prevention has a big climate saving potential. So it should be also possible to include it in the EU climate policies, in the EU market policies. I already talked about agriculture, common agricultural policy. So yes, this is our aim also for food waste. Then of course, evidence base for food waste prevention, because we like to avoid greenwashing, and now it's really hard to say what is work, what is not, because a lot of actions on food waste cannot be easily measured in efficiency. Education is important, or awareness raising, but how to recalculate it on tons of food waste avoided is a big thing. And if we like to show everyone that this works, it's better that we are able to substantiate our statements with evidence. And of course, to provide support also in the way of financing research, or to extend possible and to budget possible, also co-finance direct actions. So measurement of food loss and waste. So basically, this is a prerequisite for actions by member states, that they are to collect the waste on national levels and report them to the Commission. You may, of course, heard that the mere act of measurement already is a powerful driver to avoid food waste, because once you start measure, you start to understand what is happening, and then you take actions to prevent. So 2020 is the first year for which data are to be collected by member states. Member states has 18 months to report this data, so they should come by mid-2022. And the data collection and validation is to be conducted by Eurostat. On the website of Eurostat is reporting manual and questionnaire. Of course, this is the first reporting year, and for sure this will not be perfect, but But I mean, we need to start the quicker, the better, and we'll work on refining the data collection in coming years. And food loss measurement, we would like to be a part of research and innovation activity. As well, the calls for Horizon Europe are not yet ready, so this is all for the moment work in progress. But for sure, we are interested to check in fact how much of food is left on the field, how much is lost during harvest, and then in the early stage of storage and processing. Because without those this information, then it's much harder to and not really wise to use to then to introduce policy measures to help address the situation. And food waste prevention targets. I would say this is one of the very, very powerful instruments. I mean, if we speak about SDG, if we speak about indicative targets, if we fail to achieve them, well, I mean, nothing much happens. But if there are legally binding targets, like set, like other targets on waste recycling or waste avoidance, landfilling avoidance set in waste legislation, then it means that if the member states will fail the targets, it will start not very pleasant procedure explaining what they are planning to do to correct the situation. And if the situation is not corrected quickly, then the country is fined with simply financial fines. The process was very slow at the beginning. Now it's much quicker when the Commission cooperation with the member states, or in case of no cooperation, dealing it via court. And basically all member states then try to avoid to avoid the fines and correct the situation. I would say that mostly it's because the fines are very unpleasant for government, because opposition already usually takes it on the front pages of their newspaper that due to inaction of our Minister of Agriculture for Environment, we are risking losing hundreds of millions of euros. So I guess this is a powerful deterrent. And this is the very important instrument which basically forces member states to take it seriously, that it's no longer something which we can deliver or cannot, know that this is something which has to be delivered. But of course it means then that this will be very carefully prepared. It requires strong impact assessment, because what member states does not take obligations on them without being sure that they will be able to meet these obligations. And it needs, and it's subject to ordinary legislative procedure, former called co-decision. So in short, the member states before agreeing to such requirements, they have to approve them themselves. So, well, they discuss with European Parliament, on that it needs approval from both institutions, but it's not something which is imposed from the member states without consultations. It's something to member states has to agree, but then has to deliver. So in my view, this is the most powerful instrument in our arsenal. The Commission is to prepare a proposal based on the data reported in 2022 and table this proposal in 2023. And then the process, the legislative procedure begin. On better understanding and use of date marking, I would say it's then a more technical case. At the moment, we are collecting information, searching for scientific advice from European Food Safety Agency, So on how the food business operator determines the date marking, whether the approach should be more risk-based or other, because sometimes it's also the date marking is also used for marketing purposes rather than for food safety. So we expect to have this advice in coming months. Then our second area of research are consumers. So how they themselves understand and use this data. So then we can check how they would react for changes of technology, terminology or format, or whether to put best before date or not. We have some materials already, but we need to have more. So for that will also require public consultation and impact assessment, and should be ready by the end of 2022. Concerning scaling up action, basically it's via the EU platform and supporting instruments. So for joint research center prepares for us assessments of effectiveness of food waste prevention initiative from Refresh Horizon 2020 project, comes guidance of evaluating of household food waste, and in 2021 we would like to have improved report to identify initiatives with greater impact on food waste prevention. And we would like also to create online EU food loss and waste prevention hub, so one-stop shop for stakeholders to find the information. Okay, I will speed up, but then allowing you to read it later. Concerning the support actions, I would say this is still mainly work in progress, as it can be launched mostly in 2021. The one Green Deal call, which has been published already, I added it here, it has been published in September. The link take half a page, so I just put the reference, I guess, for everyone interested. It should be able to find it. One of the topics is specifically on farm to fork, and one of the subtopics is specifically on food waste. So I encourage you to familiarize with that. For Horizon Europe, well, the food waste comes in several intervention areas: food systems, bio-based innovation systems, circular systems. But we will know more when the calls will be published in 2021. And the new thing, which we haven't before, is single market program. Again, this is something not yet fully agreed. There are political trialogues between Commission, Parliament and Council about budget, about to which this budget can be spent, but we hope that at least part of that could be available for member states and civil society stakeholders in the form of grants and calls for proposals for specific actions. So no, not for research, but then on concrete actions to help on food waste, on food sustainability. So I would like to thank you for your patience until now. And yes, if you have any questions, especially on the food waste part, I will try to answer them as possible. So I stop sharing.
Oh. Thank you very much, Bartosz, for this very comprehensive presentation on the farm to fork strategy proposal. This is a very ambitious strategy. including various quantified targets, indeed. And we are looking forward, indeed, for extra developments of the talks between the European Commission, the Parliament, and the Council in the coming weeks and months. Before collecting and picking some questions we have so far in the chat, I have just a small question to make the link between your presentation about the Farm to Fork strategy and the Eco Waste for Food project and broader the Interreg Europe program. What about the international cooperation dimension in this regard? You have mentioned this proposal to have an EU food loss and waste prevention hub. Would such a hub function and run within an international cooperation approach, including the various stakeholders, for instance, the regional authorities behind the member states? Would it be part of such hub to facilitate knowledge, experience, knowledge exchange in such hub?
Well, let me come back. I would say yes, but maybe the first. Let me share my screen again. So the slide which I skipped earlier. So I would say that in longer term, yes. However, at the first approach or first thing, the main thing could be the database of resources. So the initiatives, calculator of impacts. So something which we would like to use from based on the results of Refresh community of expert delivery of that project, and then dedicated pages for member states policies and legislation, and then event calendar and news. So then how it will develop further from this also for regional authorities to regional authorities to share, it's the thing for discussing. I would say in the longer term, yes, we would like to have one big place to help also in such actions.
Okay, thank you, Bartosz. I suggest to open the Q&A session right now. In the chat, we have a question or maybe two questions from Elisabeth Mercier. I suggest to give the floor to Ms. Mercier if she agrees. The floor is yours, Elisabeth. You have to unmute your mic, Elisabeth. No, it doesn't work. It's a question from Elisabeth. You have seen it, Bartosz, on the right.
Yes, I see the chat. So I see the two questions, actually. Yes, the one of opportunity of to support European level campaigns. I would say what we have found based on the past experience that EU level campaigns are not so effective. The problem is that they need to be much better targeted, and it's much better targeted if they are national campaigns. For EU, on the other hand, the EU can work, and it already works. If you visit the website, our website, on food waste, linked at the last page of the presentation, you will see already the elements to be used in national campaigns, as well as the other campaigns already conducted, so that the national can be prepared. On the other hand, I mean the programs, the assistance does not exclude them in advance, that if they will be called for proposals, such proposal may also be tabled. I don't think we will try to prevent it and all costs, but then it would need to be very good prepared, because I would say at the moment, based on our experience, we would rather prefer national campaigns.
Mm-hmm. There is a second question, about the standards of marketing fruit and vegetables.
Again, the problem is that everything in food waste here, it's not an easy thing. So about marketing standards, yes, they are currently subject to review. The problem that this impacts of this on food waste, as far as I know, it's not yet, I would say, not yet found and not very strict. We have seen the opinion saying that by introducing a standards, you can save food, because then at the very early stage, you already separate the things which do not have a chance to be sold, and you can process them in another way. On the other hand, there are voices saying that simply a lot of food is being wasted because of excessive consumer standards. The problem is that for the moment, we do not yet have enough evidence to support either of the statements. But for sure, yeah, I would say on the first part of the question, yes, the standards on marketing fruit and vegetables are under review.
Thank you. There is no extra question at the moment. So I suggest, if there is no question right now, that we move to there is a comment. Yeah, there is a question from Felicitas Schneider from Thunen Institute. Thanks for the interesting presentation. I did not get all issue related to the date marking slide. Will there be suggestions to prolong the best before date or having no best before date for specific food items which are identified by EFSA? There was already a trial for coffee, tea, noodles, etc. some years ago, but was stopped. Did you see that, Bartosz?
Yes. So I recall this slide. Nothing is decided. So it's something that we look forward, so we do not exclude at the moment any options. So the presence of absence of best before date and its impact on behavior, it's still at the list of option analyzed. So I can put you also in contact with my colleagues, as now. The date marking are now not part of the farm to fork unit, but part of food labeling unit. But we work closely. But I would say that for the moment, it's just information that preparatory works are ongoing, and as long as we will have something to share, I'm sure we will share. And food waste is the area where we try to be as open as possible, as we can have, we have nothing to hide here.